When the leader of the Iranian Quds military force, Qasem Soleimani, landed in Iraq, little did he know that an American drone loaded with missiles was hovering above waiting for him. As he left Baghdad airport in a convoy of two land cruisers, the drones fired their deadly payload. You must be wondering what the killing of an Iranian general has to do with gold. Answer is, quite a lot. 60% of the world's oil passes through the Strait of Hormuz. And if the US attacks Iran, resulting in the waterway getting affected, the price of oil will shoot up, dragging up prices of everything else. Travel, transport of goods, common household items that have petroleum as their base, like paints, plastics, pesticides, etc. Stock markets will fall and currencies tumble. In times of such uncertainty, people flock to buy gold, which is considered a safe haven. After American skirmishes with Iran and their attack on the Iranian general, gold prices crossed 44,000 rupees per 10 grams 24 carat, up 30% for the year, breaking the 7-year-old record, crossing $1,700 per ounce, the unit it is quoted internationally in. Not, please note, troy ounce, which is about 10% heavier than a regular ounce. The history of gold prices show how events in the Middle East tinderbox affect its price. Iran's revolution and its aftermath in the years 1977 to 79 saw an incredible 380% increase over 3 years. Likewise, the September 11, 2001 attack on the United States and the resulting American invasion of Iraq 2 years later led to more sharp surges. The biggest rise was during the period between the 2008 Asian financial crisis and the 2011 European debt crisis, where the price went up to its all-time high of $1,895. But it was still cheaper then than it is today, because back then the rupee-dollar exchange rate was between 45 and 55, while now it has dropped to almost 75. Now it is the US-China trade war, combined with US-Iran tensions, compounded by unknown effects of the coronavirus on supply chains, that are responsible for the current spike. Geopolitical tensions elsewhere, like Brexit, Catalonia's claim of independence, blasts in Sri Lanka and the Hong Kong protests, also contribute to gold's volatility, but do not affect its price by much. Instead, it is the US Federal Reserve's policy that plays a greater role. When the Fed lowers interest rates, returns on gold look more attractive, leading to a gradual rise in prices. All this uncertainty, however, makes central banks diversify their monetary reserves away from paper currencies and into gold, some of whom have vast stores of gold collected over decades. Gold is a finite resource, with new discoveries of large mines being increasingly rare, and miners have to dig deeper to access quality gold.
Till the 80s, we always found new mines with 30 to 50 million ounces of deposits, but in the last 15 years, we haven't found any.
Over the last decade, mined gold has fallen to just 3,000 tons per annum. 1 ton double NE or metric ton is 1,000 kilos. 1 ton with a single N is 907 kilos. India was among the largest importers of gold until China overtook it in 2013. But it still spends a large part of its foreign exchange buying this precious metal, costing the country $30 billion last year, or 2,10,000 crore rupees. In an effort to discourage gold imports, India's government has increased import duties to 12.5% and GST to 3%. But by doing so, offered arbitrage opportunities for gold smuggling, estimated to be $7 billion alone in FY 19-20. Half of all purchases in India are related to marriages. The top spenders during marriages are Malayalis, Andhraites and Tamilians, followed by Mangalorians, Maharashtrians and Bengalis. The South accounts for 40% of all gold bought, more than the North and East combined. Buying physical gold is the oldest way of accumulating savings, acting as a social security for women. allowing the poor, in the absence of bank lockers in rural areas, to safely carry their wealth with them at all times. But saving in this way is inefficient, as making and melting charges for the jewellery are as high as 15 to 25% and rob the owner of all appreciation in gold prices. New methods of investment in gold via mutual funds like installment schemes may lead to a lowering of demand for physical gold, while at the same time allowing smaller investors to buy the expensive metal in affordable quantities like 1 gram every month, turn it into physical gold whenever they want or at the end of a particular period, or sell it at any time and benefit from price appreciation without loss of making charges. While sovereign gold bonds issued by the Reserve Bank of India every 2 to 3 months is a good option for large investors wanting to diversify their holdings. Funnily enough, the oldest form of investment, gold, has many things in common with the newest form of investment, Bitcoin, even though the digital currency has no underlying value. Both are available in limited quantity. Total gold mined by the world till date is between 170 to 190,000 tons, while Bitcoin is designed to have an upper limit of 21 million. Both are difficult to mine. Digitally, both can be bought in minuscule quantities. Both cannot be destroyed, and both are recognized globally. Considering regular political and health crises across the world, and China's move to challenge the dollar as the world's reserve currency, gold may see its price rise to newer heights in the future. Bisbo's limerick. The fascination with gold has been constant through the ages. In the early days, it was used to pay our wages. Now it's used as a backup whenever the world gets a hiccup. When all indicators point down, it's only gold that rages. Subscribe to Bisbo and click on the bell icon to get notified whenever Bisbo releases a new video. Sources of all our information is listed in the video description section.